Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to appreciate the Lord right now, whatever you understand about it. The Bible says that He alone deserves to be praised. The Bible says that the true worshippers shall worship the Father in truth and in spirit. That is why anytime we have opportunity to come in front or in the midst of His people, out of our soul, our spirit, ladies and gentlemen, we should worship Him well. Some people are dead and gone. One day, some days of your life, just visit the mortuary. Some of these people are more beautiful than you. They are more handsome than you. But they are dead and gone. When you are still alive, and there is breath in you, and you can move here and there, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great opportunity. And that is why when we are worshiping, we are praising Him, you should not undermine it. Lift up your hands. Thank you, Jesus. No one else like You. Thank You, Jesus. He's able. Lift up your hands. Because the days and times are even getting nearer. Lift up your hands up to heaven. Lift up your hands up to heaven. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Let your fire.
Let your fire.
Say, Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Let your fire.
Let your fire.
Fall. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Pray in tongues now. Open your mouth and pray. Let your fire.
Yeah.
Somebody shout and say, Amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Put your hands together. We thank God for your life. We thank God for what God is about to do. Amen.
Amen.
It is very important that as I will say, every day of your life, the only thing that will help you is to spend much of your days in the house of God. We have no better place. We have no better place. Almost like a mountain, you know, almost like a mountain. I've been treating a certain subject, and I just want to, keep on hitting on it. And it's very important and very obvious that every day of our life, you see, days and times, we are growing. We are doing what? We are growing. And things are going. And time is not on our side. And that is why whatever you're doing, you have to prepare yourself well. There were some few people that came in the other time. I was teaching them about the ant. And how the ant prepares itself in the time of the summer, in the time of the winter. And even how the ants are much united, in a quote, more than human beings. You see, an ant, sometimes you could see that they want to roll something, but he'll try his best. But sometimes it will be funny difficult to do that. But you go and, call his friends or his brothers, and he'll come. And by the time you look at it again, they'll come in a bundle. And they are able to do that. That means that anything we want to do on this earth, when we come together as a family, when we come together as one people, when we come together as one nation, anything we want to do, we will be able to do it. Even sometimes you enter into a family and there is no unity in the family. Everyone wants to do his own thing. This one is doing his there. Another one is doing his somewhere. And that is why we can't do much. But anytime we love ourselves and we can help ourselves, and you think about me and I think about you, ladies and gentlemen, anything we want to do, we can accomplish it.
Yes.
When you look through the Bible, in the book of Genesis, the Bible says, chapter number 6, there were some people, they did not know about God. They wanted to build a tower unto heaven. In their mind, they said, let us build a tower so that we may have a name on this earth. They were unbelievers. They were people that doesn't know about God. But the Bible says that once they came together and they were trying to build up, I'm telling you, God himself was afraid of them. And God said, if I don't come down and cause confusion among these people, whatever they decide to do, they can do it.